We want to solve the given exponential equations using logarithms. In general, to solve an exponential equation with one exponential part, we want to isolate the exponential part and then take either the common log or natural log of both sides of the equation, and this will allow us to solve for x. Looking at our first example, we have 7 raised to the power of 4x plus 1 equals 128. Notice how the exponential part is already isolated on the left side of the equation. So we can start by taking the log of both sides of the equation. I'm going to take the natural log of both sides. So we'll have the natural log of 7 raised to the power of 4x plus 1 equals the natural log of 128. And now since our goal is to solve for x, we can move x out of the exponent position by applying the power property of logarithms, which means we can take this exponent here and move it to the front. So it's going to be the quantity 4x plus 1 times natural log 7. And now we want to solve for x, so what we're going to do here is clear the parentheses by distributing natural log 7 and then solve for x. So we'll have 4x natural log 7 plus natural log 7 equals natural log 128. Now this may look a little strange, but this is really just a basic two-step equation. To solve this equation for x, we'll start by undoing this addition by subtracting natural log 7 on both sides of the equation. This would be 0, so we have 4x natural log 7 equals natural log 128 minus natural log 7. Remember, we cannot subtract these because these are not like logarithms. And now to solve for x, we need to divide. So we'll divide by 4 natural log 7 on both sides. Notice on the left side, 4 over 4 simplifies to 1. Natural log 7 over natural log 7 simplifies to 1. So we have x equals this quotient, but now we'll have to use the calculator to get a decimal approximation. So we'll have a set of parentheses around the numerator and the denominator. So we'll have an open parenthesis, natural log 128 minus natural log 7. So there's the numerator divided by our denominator of 4 natural log 7. And it's typical to round to 4 decimal places, so x is approximately 0.3734. And to check this, we want to raise 7 to the power of 4 times 0.3734 plus 1, and this should be approximately equal to 128. Let's go ahead and check to make sure that our solution here is correct. We did round up slightly, therefore the value is a little bit larger than 128, but this does verify our solution. Let's take a look at another example. Here we have e raised to the power of 2x minus 5 equals 61. Again, the exponential part is already isolated, but since here we have base e, it's going to be easier if we use the natural log rather than the common log. So if we take the natural log of both sides of the equation, we would have natural log of e raised to the power of 2x minus 5 equals natural log 61. And again, we can move x out of the position of the exponent by applying the power property of logarithms. So we'll move this to the front. So now we have the quantity 2x minus 5 times natural log e equals natural log 61. Now notice in the previous example, we distributed the natural log and then solved for x. But natural log e is equal to 1. Remember, natural log e is log base e, so this simplifies to the exponent, which we would raise this base e to obtain e, which would be equal to 1. E to the first is equal to e. You're still not convinced, of course, we can do this on the calculator. Natural log e is equal to 1. And since this simplifies to 1, we just have the quantity 2x minus 5 equals natural log 61. So we'll add 5 to both sides of the equation. This would be 2x equals, this would be 0, natural log 61 plus 5, and then divide both sides by 2. So we have x equals this quotient here. We'll go ahead and get a decimal approximation. Natural log 61 plus 5, divide all of this by 2. So x is approximately 4.5554. Which means if we take e and raise it to the power of 2 times 4.5554 and subtract 5, this should be approximately equal to 61. Let's go ahead and check that. So we press second natural log, brings up e raised to the power of, and then we'll have 2 times 4.5554 minus 5. So all this is our exponent, and this is approximately equal to 61. Okay, that's going to do it for these two examples. We'll take a look at two more examples in the next video.